The Houston Museum of Natural Science has reopened, but how safe is it to visit? Unsurprisingly, science has the answer.
I think we're the safest place on the planet. We are so obsessed with not causing the spread of COVID-19 that it's really incredible. If you look behind me, you see we're a big space, and lots of air is really important. Don't go to confined spaces with lots of people. It's way too easy for the virus to move around. But if the area is big, if you'll look, you'll see that's our Mars garden, one of our exhibits, and the interns are behind it that actually planted the plants and know how to grow plants on Mars and eventually how to kill, and even also how to kill some. And in front, you see we have actually moved the guardrails out more so that the person cannot be within 6 feet of the person that's visiting. So we believe in 6 feet, we believe in masks, and we believe in just not crowding people together. Also, we wipe our surfaces, and we have Purell every time you turn around, so you can keep wiping your hands too. And we wipe our restrooms, and we really, as I say, the Science Museum probably is part of why we do this. We're just obsessed. Oh, I have become an expert on theaters and why theaters have so much trouble with people and the virus. So we got to practice on some, we had some campers coming in June. So we practiced on them and we figured out how do we keep people totally safe? That means no one's in front of you, no one's behind you, and no one's less than two seats away from you except your own kids. No fair separating your own children. And then we looked at, well, we can do that. We can get down to about 40, 50 seats that way. Then we said, and that's a good, nice number. And then we said, well, where do theaters fall apart? And it's the queue line. Your queue line has to be 6 feet and you may not have room for it. So we took our dark light hall and made a slalom course. So you go from one side to the other side to the other side to the other side. It's kind of fun to do, actually. And the result is, because our dark light hall is about 10 feet across, you are socially distanced going all the way down the hall and then come back and you go in. Well, we got that conquered, check two. Then we said, well, everybody has to wear a mask. Then we said, well, what are we gonna do with our presenter? If a presenter wants to make announcements and talk and don't wanna sound like that. So we put shields on our presenters and that works. Then the big problem in a theater is leaving. Because, you know, people kind of come in and they understand social distancing and all. But when they leave, it's one giant clump of people trying to get out. So we dismiss them by rows, explaining that that's very important. Row one leaves, then row two is empty. Row three leaves, then row five leaves. And so as people leave, when they stand up, they're socially distanced in the row. And as they leave, they maintain that distancing down the stairs and out. And we release them at a rate that guarantees that happens. So from the moment they enter our queue line to the moment they go back into the grand hall, we have kept them the 6 feet apart that's required. And that's hard. Doing the theater, if you think about all the theaters you know of, the theater problem is the in and out part of keeping people separated.
For Great American Pastimes, this is Randall Williams.